their families, their friends in Christ. I'm grateful for your presence here this evening and for the witness of your love for Jesus and his church. I thank Bishop of Regis, Chairman of the Vicious Commission on Family and Life, for these words of welcome on your behalf, and in a special way, I thank those who have presented testimonies. Thank you. And have shared the life of faith with us. The Church in the Philippines is blessed with the apostolate of many movements dedicated to the family, and I thank them for their witness. The scriptures seldom speak on St. Joseph, but when they do, we often find him resting. As an angel reveals God's will to him in his dreams. In the gospel passage we have just heard, we find Joseph resting not once, but twice. This evening, I would like to rest in the Lord with all of you. I need to rest in the Lord with the families. And I remember my family, my father, my mother, my grandfather's mom. Today, I rest with you. And I would like to reflect with you on the gift of the family. But first, I would like to say something about the dream. But my English is so poor. If you allow me, I ask Mr. Miles to translate, and I speak in Spanish. A mí me gusta mucho esto de soñar en una familia.
I like this idea of dreaming in a family.
Toda mamá y todo papá soñó a su hijo durante 9 meses.
Every mother and father dreams of their son or daughter in the womb during 9 months.
¿Es verdad o no?
Is it true or not?
Soñar cómo será el hijo.
To dream how will your daughter or son be.
No es posible una familia sin soñar.
It is not possible to have a family without such dreams.
Cuando en una familia se pierde la capacidad de soñar, los chicos no crecen, el amor no crece, la vida se debilita y se apaga.
When you lose this capacity to dream, then you lose the capacity to love, and this energy to love is lost.
Por eso les recomiendo que a la noche, cuando hacen el examen de conciencia, se hagan también esta pregunta. ¿Hoy soñé con el futuro de mis hijos?
I recommend that at night, when you examine your consciences, ask yourselves, today, did I dream about my sons and daughters?
¿Hoy soñé con el amor de mi esposo, de mi esposa?
Did I dream of the love of my husband or my wife?
¿Hoy soñé con mis padres y mis abuelos que llevaron la historia hasta mí?
Did I dream of my parents, my family?
Es tan importante soñar. Primero de todo, soñar en una familia. No pierdan esta capacidad de soñar.
It is so important to dream and to dream in the family. Please don't lose this ability to dream in this way.
Y viví aquí. Y también, ¿cuántas dificultades en la vida del matrimonio se solucionan si nos tomamos un espacio de sueño?
And how many solutions are found to family problems if we take time to reflect?
Si nos detenemos y pensamos en el cónyuge, en la cónyuge.
If we think of our husband or wife,
y soñamos con las bondades que tiene, las cosas buenas que tiene,
and we dream about the good qualities that they have.
Por eso es muy importante recuperar el amor a través de la ilusión de todos los días. Nunca dejen de ser novios.
Don't ever lose the illusion of when you were boyfriend and girlfriend.
Very important, guys. Joseph Christ revealed God's will to him. In this moment of rest in the Lord, as we pause from our many daily obligations and activities, God is also speaking to us. He speaks to us in the reading we have just heard, in our prayer and witness, and in the quiet of our heart. Let us reflect on what the Lord is saying to us, especially in this evening's gospel. There are three aspects of this passage which I would ask you to consider. First, resting in the Lord. Second, rising with Jesus and Mary. Third, being a prophetic voice. Resting in the Lord. Rest is so necessary for the health of our minds and bodies, and often so difficult to achieve due to the many demands placed on us. But rest is also essential for our spiritual health, so that we can hear God's voice and understand what He asks of us. Joseph was chosen by God to be the foster father of Jesus and the husband of Mary. As Christians, you too are called, like Joseph, to make a home for Jesus. To make a home for Jesus. You make a home for Him in your heart, your families, your parishes, and your communities. To hear and accept God's call to make a home for Jesus, you must be able to rest in the Lord. You must make time each day for resting in the Lord. Yes, for prayer. Prayer is resting in God. But you might say to me, I know that. Holy Father, I want to pray, but there is so much work to do. Yes? I must care for my children. I have chores in the home. I am too tired, even to sleep well. That is right. That's right. This might be true, but if we do not pray, we will not know the most important thing of all. God's will for us and for all world activity, our busyness with our prayer, we will accomplish very little. Resting in prayer is especially important for families. It is in the family that we first learn how to pray. And don't forget, when the family pray together, remain together. It's important. There, we come to know God, to grow into men and women of faith, to say ourselves as members of God's great family, the church. In the family, we learn how to love, how to forgive, how to be generous and open, non-close and selfish. We learn to move beyond our own needs to encounter others and share our lives with them. That is why it is so important to pray as family. So important. That is why families are so important in the God's plans for the church. Resting in Lord is to pray. Pray together in family. Yo quisiera también decirles una cosa muy personal.
I would also like to say something very personal to you this evening.
Yo quiero mucho a San José.
I like St. Joseph very much.
Porque es un hombre fuerte y de silencio.
He was a strong man of silence.
Y en mi escritorio,
and on my desk,
tengo una imagen de San José durmiendo.
I have an image of St. Joseph sleeping.
Y durmiendo cuida la iglesia.
Escuché.
Durmiendo cuida la iglesia.
Sleeping, he looks after the church.
Yes, he can do it. We know. Y cuando tengo un problema, una dificultad, yo escribo un papelito y lo pongo debajo de San José.
When I have a problem or a difficulty, I write on a piece of paper and I put it underneath his statue.
Para que lo sueñe.
So that he can dream about it.
Esto significa para que rece por ese problema.
This means that you please pray St. Joseph for this problem.
The second aspect, rising with Jesus and Mary. Those precious moments of repose, of resting with the Lord in prayer, are moments we might wish to prolong. But like Saint Joseph, once we have heard God's voice, we must rise from our slumber. We must get up and act. In the family, we must get up and act. Faith does not remove us from the world, but draws us more deeply into it. This is very important. We must go deeply in the world, but with the force of the prayer. Each of us, in fact, has a special role in preparing for the coming of God's kingdom in our world. Just as the gift of Holy Family was entrusted to Saint Joseph, so the gift of the family And its place in God's plan is entrusted to us. Lo mismo que con San José.
It's the same with St. Joseph.
San José, el regalo de la Sagrada Familia le fue encomendado para que lo llevara adelante.
The gift of the Holy Family is given so it be taken forward.
A cada uno de ustedes y de nosotros, porque yo también soy hijo de una familia.
I'm also a son of a family, and to you, all of you, with.
Nos entregan el plan de Dios para llevarlo adelante.
We are given the plan of God to take forward.
The angel of the Lord revealed to Joseph the dangers which threatened Jesus and Mary, forcing them to flee to Egypt and then to settle in Nazareth. So too in our time, God calls upon us to recognize the dangers threatening our own families and to protect them from harm. And be attentive. Be attentive with the new ideological colonization. There existen colonizaciones ideológicas.
There is a colonization, an ideological colonization that we have to be careful of.
Que buscan destruir la familia.
That tries to destroy the family.
No nacen del sueño, de la oración, del encuentro con Dios, de la misión que Dios nos da.
It's not born of the dream that we have with God from prayer and from the mission that God gives us.
Vienen de afuera.
It comes from outside.
Por eso dijo que son colonización.
And that's why I say it's colonization.
No perdamos la libertad de la misión que Dios nos da, la misión de la familia.
Let us not lose the freedom that the mission, to take that mission forward that God has given us.
Y así como nuestros pueblos en un momento de su historia llegaron a la madurez de decirle no a cualquier colonización política.
And just as our peoples were able to say no to the period of colonization,
como familia tenemos que ser muy, muy sagaces, muy hábiles, muy fuertes para decir no a cualquier intento de colonización ideológica sobre la familia.
As families, we have to be very wise and very strong with fortitude to say no to these initiatives of colonization that could destroy the family.
Y pedirle a San José, que es amigo del ángel, que nos mande la inspiración de saber cuándo podemos decir sí y cuándo debemos decir no.
And to ask the intercession of Saint Joseph to know when to say yes and when to say no.
The pressures on family lives today are many. Here in the Philippines, countless families are still suffering from the effects of natural disasters. The economic situation has caused families to be separated. We have heard by migration. And the search for employment and financial problems strain many households. While all too many people live in dire poverty, others are caught up in materialism and lifestyles, which are destructive of family life and the most basic demands of Christian morality. Those are the ideological colonization. The family is also threatened by growing efforts on the part of some to redefine the very institution of marriage by relativism, by the culture of the ephemeral, by a lack of openness to life. Pienso en el Beato Pablo VI.
I think of Paul the Sixth, Blessed Paul the Sixth.
En un momento donde se le proponía el problema del crecimiento de la población.
In a moment of that challenge of the growth of populations.
Tuvo la valentía.
He had the strength.
De defender la apertura a la vida de la familia.
To defend openness to life.
Él sabía las dificultades que había en cada familia. Por eso, en su carta encíclica, era tan misericordioso con los casos particulares.
He knew the difficulties that families experience, and that's why in his encyclical he expressed compassion for particular cases.
Y pidió a los confesores que fueran muy misericordiosos y comprensivos con los casos particulares.
And he taught professors to be particularly compassionate with particular cases.
Pero él miró más allá.
But he went further.
Miró a los pueblos de la tierra.
He looked to the peoples beyond.
Y vio esta amenaza de destrucción de la familia por la privación de los hijos.
He saw the lack and the problem that it could cause families in the future.
Pablo VI era valiente.
Paul the Sixth was courageous.
Era un buen pastor.
He was a good pastor.
Y alertó a sus ovejas
and he warned
sobre
his
los lobos que venían.
And he warned his sheep about the wolves that were approaching.
Que desde el cielo nos bendiga esta tarde.
And from the heavens he blesses us today.
God needs good and strong families to overcome these threats. The Philippines needs holy and loving families to protect the beauty and truth of the family in God's plan and to be a support and example for others' families. Every threat to the family is a threat to society itself, the future of humanity, as Saint John Paul II often said, passes through the family. The future passes in the family. So protect your families. Protect your families. Send them your country's greatest treasure and nourish them always by prayer and the grace of the sacraments. Families will always have their trials, but may you never add to them. Instead, by living examples of love, forgiveness, and care. Be sanctuaries of respect for life, proclaiming the sacredness of the every human life from conception to natural death. What a gift this will be society if every Christian family lived fully its noble vocation. So, rise! with Jesus and Mary and set out on the path the Lord traces for each of you. Finally, the gospel we have heard reminds us of our Christian duty to be prophetic voices in the midst of our communities. Joseph listened to the angel of the Lord and responded to God's call to care for Jesus and Mary. In this way, he played this part in God's plan and became a blessing not only for the Holy Family, but a blessing for all humanity. With Mary, Joseph served as a model for the boy Jesus as he grew in wisdom, age, and grace. When families bring children into the world, train them in faith and sound values, and teach them to contribute to society, they become a blessing in our world. A family can become a blessing to the world. God's love becomes present and active by the way of love and by the good works that we do. Who extends Christ's kingdom in this world? And in doing this, we prove faithful to the prophetic mission which we have received in baptism. During this year, which your bishops have set aside as the year of the poor, I would ask you as families to be especially mindful of our call to be missionary disciples of Jesus. This means being ready to go beyond your homes and to care for your brothers and sisters who are the most in need. I ask you especially to show concern for those who do not have a family of their own, in particular, those who are elderly and children without parents. Never let them feel isolated, alone, and abandoned, but help them to know that God has not forgotten them. Hoy quedé sumamente conmovido en el corazón después de la misa.
I was very moved after the Mass today.
Cuando visité ese hogar de niños solos, sin familia.
When I visited that shelter, that home for children who had no parents.
¿Cuánta gente trabaja en la iglesia para que ese hogar sea una familia?
How many people in the church work so that that house is a home, a family?
Esto significa llevar adelante proféticamente qué significa una familia.
This is what it means to take forward prophetically the meaning of a family.
You may be poor yourself in material ways, but you have an abundance of gifts to offer when you offer Christ and the community of his church. Do not heed your faith. Do not heed Jesus, but carry him into the world and offer the witness of your family life. Dear friends in Christ, know that I pray for you always. I pray today for the family. That is right. I do it. I pray that the Lord may continue to deepen your love for Him, and that this love may manifest itself in your love for one another and for the church. Don't forget, Jesus sleeping. Don't forget, Joseph sleeping. Jesus slept in the bed. But the protection of Joseph. Don't forget the sleep in the family. It's a prayer. Don't forget prayer for the family. Pray often and take the fruits of our prayer into the world, that all may know Jesus Christ and His merciful love. And please, sleep also for me. Pray for me. Pray also for me. Oh, I truly need your prayers. I will depend on them always. Thank you very much.